someone asked, like, what's your bear thesis of Tesla? Like, where does it go wrong? And to me, it goes wrong of, like, Elon not wanting to make money. That's, like, the biggest red flag in my potential. Of all the, like, reasons I'm like, oh, what would Tesla do wrong? Like, Elon's just like, screw it. We'll sell these cars at a 5% margin because, like, right. we want everyone to have them. So do you ever think about that as an investor? Because this is hitting on the nail on the head of, like, yeah. ARC's model, which also a bunch of people have asking for, like, oh, Tesla's going to extend a 40% gross margin, sort of assuming.
I don't think that will ever happen.
The trend has been they actually keep their gross margin steady mm-hmm. around this 20, 25% range, lower price, lower access to the technology. Does that reach an inflection point with maybe not the Model 3, but the Model 2, $25,000 car, where they will eventually, maybe it's the robo-taxi network that really takes those margins to the next level. But do you ever, you know, how do you balance that view of Tesla? Of like, oh, it's a social good. We love the mission, but it's, you know, there's $160 billion of value priced in. There's $1 trillion of value priced in. We need to be generating a huge return of cash flow.
Right. A couple of points that I want to make on that. And first, we'll start with sort of the second point you made, which was like the 40% gross margin thing. I don't think Tesla will ever do that unless they are production constrained to the point where they sort of have to do that, if that makes sense, where lowering the price on whatever service or vehicle that they're selling does not drive any incremental demand because they simply cannot produce anything more or they cannot offer more autonomous miles, anything like that, because they're literally just producing as much as they can. And that's historically pretty much what we have seen from Tesla. There's been some up and down, obviously, but if you look largely and zoom out over the last 10 years, Tesla has been production constrained.
Yeah.
So depending on how production constrained they are versus the level of demand, you might see some periods of time where the gross margin does spike a little bit as Tesla sort of optimizes the cash flow around their production constraint. But over time, I expect them to pretty much just hold to that, you know, 25% gross margin and put that back into expanding volume wherever possible. So I think that's the first piece on margin. You might see those temporary periods of time. The second piece on Elon in terms of, you know, is he properly aligned with growing the value of the organization or is he just trying to put as many electric vehicles into the market? I used to have worries about that. That was one of my main concerns when I first invested in Tesla is like, all right, is this more altruistic or is there potential for real returns here as a business? And I think a lot of people have had that question. The new Elon Musk compensation plan is very well incentivized for Elon to grow shareholder value. If it doesn't grow, even if that's because of dilution, because of too many capital raises or things like that, he doesn't get paid. His compensation grants him stock options at around $350 per share. Even if the market cap's $1 trillion, but the dilution is such that the share price is still $350 per share, he doesn't make any money, nothing. He needs to make money for SpaceX. So that's your alignment right there.
Yeah.
That's all you need to know.
Like, and he said Mars is extremely expensive and I want to accumulate assets on Earth. And I'm hoping Elon is like bought into this theory that I have of like, if you actually want to have a sustainable enterprise, it does need to produce a profit.
And like, he has mentioned that before. Yeah, that's like the only fair criticism, not the only fair, but one of the fair criticisms of Tesla has been that it has not been a profitable business. And he's specifically mentioned that.
Yeah. So. And that's like why I love Elon because he's so humble. And even I was like, bro, slow down. Like we've been growing like crazy, investing like, in all this new tech.
There are no fair criticisms.
Like, no, there are, but like, I actually don't really care if Tesla's super profit. Like,
yeah, no, I don't
super
either.
Profit. And I think like, it's a fair point, but does it tell the whole story? And is Tesla's unprofitability in their earlier years justified? Yes, totally.
Right.
And they did this G check this year and went, you know, cash flow positive. And that's kind of been my big takeaway is like, we proved the products work. That's been years ago. But now do we prove this could be a financially viable product and the business model works? That's what happened in 2019. That's what is the execution that's boosting the intrinsic value of the stock.